IBS Hyderabad PhD program has collaborations with 9 universities across the globe, such as Bentley University, Syracuse University, Memphis, Toledo, etc. And all the conference, whatever the IBS Hyderabad conducts, try to conduct having collaborations with good institutes, such as the Bombay Stock Exchange, the Indian Institute of Capital Market, ICIDR, and time series TICE, the Indian Econometric Society, etc. So the most of the cases, the top people will come and deliver the keynote address for this particular conferences. For example, recently, the conference which I have conducted in April 17th and 18th on the title, The Quantitative Methods in Money, Banking, Finance and Insurance, Professor Y.K. Alag, then Professor Suresh Tendulkar, then Professor Nachineni delivered a keynote address in this particular conference. IBS Hyderabad also is having a unique feature in terms of facilitating the contributors in respect area. Recently, we have facilitated Professor Nachineni, who is the director of ICIDR, as a token of appreciation for his contributions in the area of quantitative economics and the importance of quantitative economics in other areas. The IBS Hyderabad normally identify the top academicians who have contributed to their respective field, and every year the IBS Hyderabad facilitates those particular academicians. On an average, the IBS Hyderabad faculty members as well as PhD students put together every year publish 150 research papers, and they also develop roughly 100 to 180 case studies. All research papers have published, on an average, the acceptance rate of the journal is 30%. And some faculty members have also published in top 10% journals also. See, the PhD program will help the faculty member also. It's not only the PhD students, but also it helps the faculty member. Since the PhD students is going to work under the mentorship of a faculty member for their associateship 1 as well as associateship 2, the faculty member also will get a support hand in terms of working for their research papers. That's another advantage of this particular PhD program. And this particular PhD program also will enhance the team spirit among faculty members, since the PhD students are going to work under their supervision. The purpose of this particular visiting scholar program is to fine-tune the whatever the proposal that the student has prepared under the supervision of the DAC. And another thing is the student also will get the foreign exposure by attending the classes of the mentor. Then he will also write, he or she will write the research papers, may attend the conferences. This particular visiting scholar program will be for 10 months. Then after completing the visiting scholar program, once they come back to the school, they are expected to, within 2 months, they are expected to defend their thesis proposal. After defending the thesis proposal, the student is expected to work for thesis submission. To complete all this particular program structure, the student will take 4 years. Another important feature of our program is the students who have selected for this particular program, the first year per month they will get 25,000 rupees stipend, then 10,000 as a professional development grant per year. Then once they qualify in the qualifying examination, the student will get 27,000 rupees per month plus 10,000 rupees professional development grant per year. Once the student will go to the visiting scholar program, the student will get $1,000 to $1,500 as a stipend and $750 as a professional development grant. Once they come back from visiting scholar program and defend their thesis proposal, the student will get 30,000 rupees as a stipend plus the 10,000 rupees professional development grant. Then once the student submit PhD thesis, the student will get 35,000 rupees as a stipend and 10,000 rupees as a professional development grant. Once the degree is awarded, the student will be absorbed as a faculty member, giving appropriate designation. Then then the student is expected to work for 5 years with our institute. To produce one PhD student, the IBS Hyderabad is spending 20 lakhs. That includes the scholarship whatever the students get in first year and second year, plus third year in the visiting scholar program, plus once they come back, once they defend their thesis proposal, then once they submit their PhD thesis, put together comes to 20 lakhs. These are the features of PhD program. Another highlight of our PhD program is the in associateship one, the student will be in a position, at least one case study will be developed by our PhD students. Normally, we take 20 to 25 students every year. One semester, 25 case studies will be developed by our PhD student. Similarly, second semester also, they will develop 20 to 25 case studies. Once they come to the independent study seminar, there is a concept called teaching internship. In this teaching internship, the student will also attend the classes of the faculty member, and certain classes will be independently dealt by the students. This will help them in terms of understanding the nuances that are related to the teaching. And since the students have involved in terms of developing the case studies, and IBS Hyderabad completely adopt the pedagogy of case study approach in the classroom, this particular exposure will help the students once they become the faculty member, they will be in a position to deal with the class properly. Then another highlight of this particular program is the student will be in a position to come up with 2 to 3 research articles before submission of PhD thesis itself. That also will help the student in terms of understanding how to write a research paper, and since he's going to publish in one of the top journals, and he will also get due credit, and hence whatever the publications that he or she has done, that will also the student will be in a position to take to the classroom where the learning activity of the student will be enhanced. So that's another feature of the program. Our students also going to attend so many conferences. In the process of attending these particular conferences, they will also come to know various research methodologies that are new research methodologies, especially they will come to know and try to adopt those particular methodologies in their PhD thesis work. The another important feature of this particular IBS is every year we conduct a doctoral thesis conference. In this doctoral thesis conference, we invite doctoral students who are in the verge of completing their PhD thesis, are near 2 years old PhD thesis students, will invite and ask them to present their thesis work. For this particular doctoral thesis conference, the IBS Hyderabad, the funds entire conference, the participants who selected to present their papers will get the to and fro as well as the accommodation and other hospitalities will be taken care of by the IBS Hyderabad. The advantage of this particular doctoral thesis conference, our students also will benefit by sitting this particular doctoral thesis conference, as well as the students. Normally in India, most of the conventional university PhD students do not get any opportunity to present their work. We are giving a platform to present their thesis work. Since experts will give proper comments on their thesis work, they will be in a position to work on that particular comments, and they will be in a position to submit the appropriate thesis in their respective universities. At the same time, our students also will get a lot of information about what kind of research methodology, what are the new work that is taking place in research across the globe. So that's one advantage. Similarly, we also conduct conferences on marketing, finance, HR, operations. Our students also seriously involved in these particular conferences. They will also sit through these particular conferences, and these platforms also will help them to understand the kind of research that is taking place across the country.